Hello, in this video we shall study some advanced concepts of C like arrays and pointers. C is the main language. It plays an important role while studying other programming languages. It shares same concepts as data types, control statements and many more. So that's why C forms the basis to understand and learn any other programming language. Let's start with what are arrays. Array is an ordered set of data items in a contiguous region of memory. It is defined with a data type. In this example, this ARR is an array. It is defined with a data type int, and the size of the array has to be mentioned when the array is defined. That is when the ordered set of data items is defined. Now here ARR is an array of 10 elements and each element is of type int. Okay, so these are the values that are stored in these 10 locations and these are the indices using which you can access the values. For example, ARR of 0 points to the first element, that is 23. ARR of 1 will be able to give access to the next element, that is 34. And this ARR is nothing but a variable, and all rules that are applicable to define a variable are applicable to arrays as well. Now, array is fixed in size. Now, once the array is defined, its size cannot be changed. Now, this is not going to be entirely true if we are making use of pointers. Okay, pointers is another advanced concept which is used in C, one of the most powerful concepts of C. Okay, but as far as arrays are concerned, truly once the size is defined, we cannot change the size of the array. And each element in the array occupies the amount of memory required to hold a variable of that type. For example, in int ARR, which we have seen as an example, each element is going to hold 2 bytes of memory space. So if I define an array of 10 elements, integer array of 10 elements, that is 10 into 2, it is going to occupy 20 bytes of memory space. Now, how do I initialize the array? Let's say I have an array by name mark. Mark is a variable here. Now, the size of the array is 5 elements and each element is of type int. This is the meaning of the statement. I can do the initialization when I am declaring this array, okay, as is shown here. The array can also be initialized without specifying the size. Now, if I say 5 elements here, that means the size of this array is 5. We can also as well just declare the array and store these elements by reading in through the keyboard, as we'll see in the example. Okay. Now, basically arrays are going to be used when we have related data items and we want to save them under one variable name. Say for example, I want to store the marks of all the students of a class. So that can be saved in a common array like we have defined here mark. Okay. Let's take up an example to see how I calculate average of 5 subject marks and the percentage of these marks. Okay, let me go to my online GDB. C program is already selected. So this is my program here. This is the array I have defined here to hold the subject of marks of the 5 subjects. I declare a dummy variable sum which is going to add up all the marks. Okay, and I have a float variable. Is a typo here. Float variable called as average, which is going to calculate the average, right? So I am going to enter the marks through the keyboard. So I have a for loop here which is used. I start with initialization expression with I equal to 0, and the condition I check is I is less than 5. So in each of the iteration I am reading the value of the marks and I am storing it in the array marks. Okay, then let me display if all the elements have been read properly, right? And then I try to calculate the sum here. Sum plus is equal to marks I is going to add up the elements of the array marks. Okay, And then once I come out of this for loop, the sum of all the marks are available in this variable sum, and I calculate the average by dividing the sum by 5 as I am entering the 5 subject marks. Okay, so let me quickly run and show you the results here. So enter 5 integers. So let me enter 21, 22, 23, 21, 24. So these are the 5 subject marks. Okay, so now 5 subject marks are displayed here. Okay, so let me quickly have a printf statement in this program to print the average. Okay, printf average equal to, as average is a floating point variable, I will give it as percentage f. Okay, so let me print average. Okay, so quickly run through the program again. So 5 integers have to be entered. Okay, so what you see here, the average marks is 22. So now likewise, you can have a hands-on practice using this same program. You can try to calculate the percentage. Define one more variable called as percentage here and calculate the percentage by using this average value. Okay. So this was the example on arrays. Now, we can also have multi-dimensional arrays. We can create an array of arrays in C language. These are called as multi-dimensional arrays. Now, for example, I can have something like float x 3, 4. So that means I will have 3 by 4. That is, I can save 12 elements. Okay. So this is the picture here, which shows an array of size 3 by 4. So I have 3 rows and 4 columns. Now each of these elements can be accessed with 2 indices now. So row 1 and column 1, we access it using the index x00. Now this is x01. The first index corresponds to the row and the second index corresponds to the column. Now the example which is shown here is an array C with 2 rows and 3 columns, and this is the initialization which is done here. This is the initialization for the first row and this is the initialization for the second row. So we can as well make use of 2D arrays. Now this is called as a 2D array because there are 2 dimensions. We can also have 3D arrays. Okay. Now if I have to give you an example, a real time example as to why 2D array is required. Basically these 2D arrays are required to represent images. We want to represent the pixels. So the image is represented in the form of matrix or 2D array. And also we can, if I have something like, I have 10 students and I want to store 5 subject marks for each of these students. So those 10 students will act as rows here and 5 subject marks will act as columns here. So I will need a 2D array. Okay. So these are few of the examples where 2D arrays can be used. Now next, there is one more advanced concept in C, a very helpful concept which is called as pointers. Let me just give you some basic idea of what pointers are. Pointer is a variable that is going to contain a memory address. Okay. Now this address might be that of another variable or it could point to any of the memory location. Okay. So sometimes C is also referred to as language of pointers. So for example, I have here int star p. Now star is a unary operator which is going to be used to define the pointers, remember that. Okay, so let's have an example here. I have a variable x which is initialized to 5, then I have another integer variable called as y. Now once I say int star p, that means p is a pointer variable of type integer, so that means it can point to any location which is holding integer data. Okay. Now p is equal to and x. Now what is this ampersand x? Ampersand x refers to the address of the variable. Okay. Now p is pointing or holding the address of this variable x. Okay. Now if I do something like this, y is equal to star p, what will happen? I can access the content of x. Okay. Now p is pointing to, once I say p is equal to and x, now let's say this is the location where my data x is present. Okay, so I have a pointer p which is pointing to this location x. Okay, once I say p is equal to and x, that means it is holding the address of this location. Now let's say the address of this location is 100. So now value of the value 100 is stored here. Now once I say y is equal to star p, that means I am referring to content of p. Now p was holding the value of 100, which is the address of x. Okay, so once I say y is equal to star p, content of x is going to be saved here. Now if the content of x is 1, so y will be 1. Now what is the use of this indirect access of the variable? Sometimes it may so happen that I while writing the programs, I keep on overwriting the variables which I cannot afford to lose. Okay, in such cases pointers are going to be very helpful. Okay, that's all in this video. Coming up next, we will study something on functions, how to write functions and what are the return types, how to use arguments in functions and all. Thank you.